In this video, we'll be adding a dark mode to your WordPress website. I'm first going to show you the free version, and after that, I'm going to buy the pro version so you can see if it will fit your need. If you want to help me out, go to wp.discount/darkmode. This link is also in the description and in the comments of this video. I will be forever grateful. And then we also have a 35% discount on WP Dark Mode using this link. So that's really great. Let's go over here to pricing. The beauty of this, it also has a lifetime deal for 50 websites. We only pay $174, which is already a 30% discount. If you want to use it on unlimited sites, well, 1,000 sites, it's only $226. I'm gonna buy this one as also for my clients, and I really like this. Log into your WordPress website. If you're still logging in using WP Admin, that's not a very safe way. So please watch my tutorial about securing your WordPress website. And then we go on the left side to plugins, add new plugin. And then we're gonna search for the plugin Dark Mode WP Pool. And then we can see this plugin and we're going to install it. And then we press activate. Here we can allow or no thanks. All right, let's head over here to the settings on the left side. The first option is a very neat one. If you just want to test it out only for you, you can disable this, and then you're the only person who can see the dark mode on your website while being logged in. So this way we can tune and tweak it without going already live. So that's a very nice feature. And then we can choose how we want to use the dark mode. Light, dark, or use the system settings of your visitor. I would really advise you to use the system settings because in general, people already have set up their browser to go to dark mode or their OS on their mobile phones or on their computers. Just keep it like this. This is great. Then we go over here to the admin panel dark mode. If I enable this one and I press save changes, you will see over here a button appearing and switch it to dark mode. And now the backend is also in dark mode. Now this can be very useful if you create content during hours that you actually need to sleep. So that's also possible. And you can also use this on the block editor when working in Gutenberg. Then we go over here to customization and the switch settings. In here we have three kinds of switches. The floating switch, the menu switch, and the content switch. Well, the floating switch is the only thing available for free in this plugin. But we're going to upgrade to a paid plugin in just a second. And I'm going to show you also these two. The floating switch can be this one, light, dark, or this one. I really like this switch. But if you have the pro version, we can try any of these, which also look really great. But we can customize it. We can make it small, medium, large, double, XL, or even custom. And then you can just make it the exact size that you would like to have. I'm going with the S feature. It looks great. Switch it to the left or the right. And if you want to make it custom, we have to buy the pro version. And then we also have the switch attention effect, wobble or vibrate, really great. Let's scroll up and then we go to the menu switch. Well, I actually wanted to have it in the menu, but then we need the ultimate version. So I'm gonna buy that in just a second, hold on. If we then go to color settings, we can choose the color mode for our dark mode. You have the automatic color, but you also have color presets. So you can choose, for example, this blue and black or orange black and all these different kind of things, or you can make a custom preset. That's really great. So you can actually style it in the way of your own branding colors. We are going with the automatic color just for now. In the free version, we can only choose these two, but as you can imagine, the custom preset is actually really gold. I'm gonna show you that in just a second. Then we go to image setting. We can actually replace images. If you have images that won't switch to the dark mode, then we can just replace them with a dark version over here. We can also go to image behavior, and here you can enable the low brightness of the image or even a grayscale image. Well, let's turn this off right now and see how my website looks on the front end before enabling these things. Then we go to video settings. You can also replace videos and also the video behavior. Then we go to site animations, and here we can enable a page transition. So if you go from light to dark, you will see this thing happening on your website. Let's use the fade in feature. Let's go to advanced. In here, we can go to performance. We can only choose this if we have a ultimate version. This looks great. We can also go to exclude settings. exclude elements or include elements on the page posts. And we also have WooCommerce on this website, so we can also exclude products and categories. We can also add in some custom CSS to style it even further for our dark mode. That's really great. Let's go to accessibility. We can adjust the typography for dark mode with the ultimate version. We have also a keyboard shortcut, and you can use URL parameters for tracking purposes. So you can see ? dark mode or ? light mode. That can be useful in some cases. Then we can have a shortcode. In here, we can generate a shortcode, which is really nice. This way, we can actually place this button anywhere on the website we want using our page builder. That's really nice. We won't be using it, but it's very nice to have it. We also have a switch widget. This is a bit of a tutorial how to add it to your widget somewhere on your website. If you have a theme that supports widgets and you're using them a lot, this is the way to go. We're not going to use it as we're using Elementor on this website. And this plugin actually creates a basic element or widget, as you want to call it, for Elementor. So we will not be needing this widget. Let's go to analytics in here. And if you have the ultimate version, you can actually see how many people are using dark mode. And this will be very interesting later on. All right, let's see how my website looks on the front end. To test this plugin, we'll be using my latest Elementor Pro and WooCommerce tutorial website. I'll teach you exactly how to build this in this tutorial, so make sure to check it out, as it is a 4-hour long tutorial, and I'll show you the ins and outs of creating your very own e-commerce website. If we now click on this button, things actually change, but my search bar is not completely visible anymore, so we need to tune that one. And also my images need to be replaced, as they were just JPGs with white backgrounds, just for the ease of this tutorial. And also the logos, as you can see, it needs some polishing. Then this looks actually pretty great. Let's see how a product looks like. And here we are at a product. As you can see, the black one needs to be replaced by a white font. And the images, well, I definitely have to re-upload all images within a dark mode because it just doesn't look that great. The background is not that great because I have changed all backgrounds on my website to this light color in here, this broken white color, which looks great, but not so much on the dark mode. And when I refresh this page, you can also see this wobble inside of here, which I actually don't like, so I'm gonna turn that off right now. But as you can see, it's a really fast one. So now you have a good impression of how it looks like on your website. If this is a professional website and I'm building in my dark mode for my client or for my own web shop, I really would build in this switch and put it over here next to the language switcher. I'm going with the lifetime license, as I always like this very much. And I have more than 50 websites for all my clients and my own websites. So I'm gonna buy this one, press on buy now. Let's fill this all in. I can pay with credit card or with PayPal or wire the transfer. I'm just gonna pay with credit card, fill it all in, and then I press on pay. And after paying, we get locked in and we can go here to downloads. Click on this one, and then we can go over here and press download. After that, we go to my licenses. Then we go over here and we click to copy. Then we go back to our WordPress website and we go to plugins, add new plugin. Then we press upload plugin and we're going to upload the plugin we've just downloaded from WP Dark Mode and press install now. Activate plugin. And then we're going to paste in the key we've just copied from the website. Here we are, and press activate license. My license have been activated. Excellent job. Let's go back to the settings. And now all the options are available for us. Let's go to customization in here and we go to first to the switch, because I think I'm going to switch to this dark mode switch. Let's see how it looks. That's very nice. Well, I don't want to switch attention effect, as I think on my web shop I don't like it. So I'm gonna leave it to this. We can also enable a call to action. Wow, this is very big. I don't want this, but it's possible in here. All right, press save changes. And then I go to the color settings. Of course, we can use all these kinds of things, but I actually want to create my own color custom preset. So we click on this one, we press gun it, and we're gonna add a custom color preset. Then we're gonna click on this one, and we're gonna scroll down, and we can change the name, dark mode. And And if we then want to customize it, well, it's pretty easy. Let's go with the body background color. I use this dark in the menu and also this dark in the footer. So I'm going to use this very dark one as the primary color and this one as the secondary color. If you want to get your own colors of your website, just right click on the front end, press on inspect. And here you can see on the right side, we are using this background color, eGlobal Color Primary. If we click on this one, we go all the way down and you can see all the color codes. I'm just gonna click on this one and press right click and just press copy. Then on here, I'm gonna click on body background color, click on it. I'm gonna switch this to hex because we have the hex code. Click on this one and then we just press paste. Here we go. And then just click somewhere else. Then we have the body background color. Great. Secondary color. I also had it in here. Secondary color. Just press on copy. We go over here, change this one to hex. And then we just click somewhere else. It's great. Then use the text color. We're just gonna use white over there. Awesome. Link colors. Let's also put it on white. But then the hover color in my website, I also use this orange color for accent color actually. So I'm gonna copy this one. And then over here, I'm gonna choose the link hover color, change it to hex and paste it in here. That's great. Here we are, this looks really nice. Then we have input fields color and I want the background color to be my secondary color. So we go, whoops, back to the hex. And here we go. All right, then we also have the input text color. I want to keep it on white. And then the placeholder color, I want this to be my dark gray over there. So I'm gonna copy this. And then the placeholder should be, here we go. And then we also have button colors, of course. So the button text color should be white. The hover text color, I'm gonna make it this orange. So go over here, copy this again, button hover text color. And the button background color, I want it to be a, well, let's use a little bit lighter gray for the button background colors because they still need to pop out a little bit. And then we have also the button border color. Should be zero because we're not using any borders. And this actually should be really great. And if you hover over it, it turns black with this. I think I like this. Press save changes. Now let me show you one more thing. I'm going to place this button over there next to the translation button. How to do that? It's pretty easy. I just go over here to templates to the theme builder of Elementor. And then I'll go into the header. I'm going to edit my header. Now on the left side, dark mode has now just added a dark mode switch in here. It just seamlessly integrates with Elementor and I can just drag and drop and put it over there next to the language switcher. As you can see, it's already inside in here. And then from inside of Elementor, if we click on it, we can choose which style we want to have. And on this website, I actually do like style number 3. Or the last one, style 13. I also like this small button, but let's go with style number 3 as everyone knows that it's a switch. Then we can also go in here and change the size of it immediately. I really like the XS style. And then if we want to make it exactly the same height as everything else, we go to advanced and we actually want to align itself on the center. And it doesn't really want to do that. So I go to my margin and I'm just going to add in some negative top margin of minus 10. This looks great. Then we press on update. And then over here, I'm just going to disable the floating switch. Press save changes. This is my beautiful web shop. Then I'm gonna turn it onto dark mode. This looks actually pretty nice. Once you've added the dark mode to your website, you might also want to add a language switcher to your website. One language is completely free. So check out this video and I'll guide you through the entire process.